Going to come a turning point in the history of Israel in the year 2017.
2017 ஆண்டிலே ஒரு பெரிய திருப்பு முனை இஸ்ரேல் சரித்திரத்திலே ஏற்பட போகிறது.
He said that will be the 70th year of the history of Israel since its formation.
அது உருவாக்கப்பட்ட நாட்களிலிருந்து அதுதான் 70வது ஆண்டாக இருக்கும்.
Therefore, I have determined that it is time to officially recognize Jerusalem as the capital of Israel. We will move the American embassy to the eternal capital of the Jewish people, Jerusalem.
And the crowd roared, but would it happen? Would, if he became president, would President Trump actually do this?
Presidents before have said it. President looks like he's gonna do it.
I know, he's saying he's gonna do it today at 1 o'clock. I think that makes Ben Shapiro pretty happy. He's the editor-in-chief of the Daily Wire, syndicated columnist and host of the Ben Shapiro Show. Ben, what are your thoughts? When did you hear that he was going to do this?
So I had heard actually sort of off the radar last week and then kept it under wraps. I was pretty excited about that. It's obviously an act of not only political bravery, but moral courage to move the embassy, but just to recognize Israel as Jerusalem as Israel's capital. The absurdity of the U.S. policy suggesting that Jerusalem was not Israel's capital has resulted in idiocies like the fact that my niece, who was born in Jerusalem, it says on her passport Jerusalem, and then it doesn't say which country she's from. Jerusalem is only important to the world because of Judaism. It's important to Christianity because it was first important to Judaism. It's important to Islam because it was forced important to Judaism. Jerusalem is mentioned hundreds of times in the Jewish texts. Jerusalem is in the Israeli national anthem. The culmination of Jewish history really was in 1967 with the recapture and the unification of Jerusalem under Judaic rule. The freedom of Jerusalem was only assured, by the way, because of that Jewish rule. What President Trump is doing is not just a recognition of reality, it's also an act of political usefulness, because all of the negotiations that have been happening for the last 20 years, for most of my lifetime, all of those negotiations have been preconditioned on stupidity, that Israel is going to give up its eternal capital, which is insane. I mean, in order to understand how dumb that is, you have to think that for Israel, Jerusalem is about 1,000 times more important than Washington, D.C. is to the United States. I mean, the founders put Washington, D.C. on a swamp because they just wanted it to be not part of any state. The reason that Jerusalem is where it is because the Bible says it is where it is. There's a religious adherence to Jerusalem that doesn't exist for normal capitals around the world. And for President Trump to recognize that this isn't going anywhere, that the freedom of Israel is just inherently connected with the freedom of Jerusalem, and that any negotiations that are to take place are going to have to be done by the Israelis themselves, and the Israelis are going to have to make decisions about what to do with their capital. Well, it's a ground shift, and it's a recognition of a reality that's necessary in order for real peace to be achieved in the region, not based on false stupidities that have been promulgated for the last couple of decades.
So they have 6 months to actually do it. They have a six-month waiver to actually do it. Monday was the deadline to actually make the announcement, so today we're going to get it today officially at 1 o'clock. But it will remain a divided city. That won't change. Does that bother you?
Well, I mean, it will remain a divided city because the fact is that the authorities have basically allowed terrorism to spread among the Palestinians, and East Jerusalem has largely been occupied by the same people it's been occupied for the last seven decades, namely Muslims who live there. That part of the city is very dangerous. It's been very dangerous ever since I can remember, long before I was born. The fact is that when I visited Israel for the first time when I was 16 years old, Israeli soldiers had to guard us as we came out of the tunnels under the Western Wall into East Jerusalem, which again, the capital of Israel. If you are a Jew and you walk into East Jerusalem, your life is in danger. If you're an Arab and you walk into West Jerusalem, there's no problem at all, which signifies exactly why Jerusalem should be under Jewish control and not under Muslim control.
Thank you. When I came into office, I promised to look at the world's challenges with open eyes and very fresh thinking. We cannot solve our problems by making the same failed assumptions and repeating the same failed strategies of the past. Old challenges demand new approaches. My announcement today marks the beginning of a new approach to conflict between Israel and the Palestinians. In 1995, Congress adopted the Jerusalem Embassy Act, urging the federal government to relocate the American embassy to Jerusalem and to recognize that that city, and so importantly, is Israel's capital. This act passed Congress by an overwhelming bipartisan majority and was reaffirmed by unanimous vote of the Senate only 6 months ago. Yet for over 20 years, every previous American president has exercised the law's waiver, refusing to move the U.S. Embassy to Jerusalem or to recognize Jerusalem as Israel's capital city. Presidents issued these waivers under the belief that delaying the recognition of Jerusalem would advance the cause of peace. Some say they lacked courage, but they made their best judgments based on facts as they understood them at the time. Nevertheless, the record is in. After more than two decades of waivers, we are no closer to a lasting peace agreement between Israel and the Palestinians. It would be folly to assume that repeating the exact same formula would now produce a different or better result. Therefore, I have determined that it is time to officially recognize Jerusalem as the capital of Israel. While previous presidents have made this a major campaign promise, they failed to deliver. Today, I am delivering. I've judged this course of action to be in the best interests of the United States of America and the pursuit of peace between Israel and the Palestinians. This is a long overdue step to advance the peace process and to work towards a lasting agreement. Israel is a sovereign nation with the right, like every other sovereign nation, to determine its own capital. Acknowledging this is a fact is a necessary condition for achieving peace. It was 70 years ago that the United States, under President Truman, recognized the State of Israel. Ever since then, Israel has made its capital in the city of Jerusalem, the capital the Jewish people established in ancient times. Today, Jerusalem is the seat of the modern Israeli government. It is the home of the Israeli parliament, the Knesset, as well as the Israeli Supreme Court. It is the location of the official residence of the Prime Minister and the President. It is the headquarters of many government ministries. For decades, visiting American presidents, secretaries of state, and military leaders have met their Israeli counterparts in Jerusalem, as I did on my trip to Israel earlier this year. Jerusalem is not just the heart of three great religions, but it is now also the heart of one of the most successful democracies in the world. Over the past seven decades, the Israeli people have built a country where Jews, Muslims, and Christians, and people of all faiths are free to live and worship according to their conscience and according to their beliefs. Jerusalem is today and must remain a place where Jews pray at the Western Wall, where Christians walk the Stations of the Cross, and where Muslims worship at Al-Aqsa Mosque. However, through all of these years, presidents representing the United States have declined to officially recognize Jerusalem as Israel's capital. In fact, we have declined to acknowledge any Israeli capital at all. But today we finally acknowledge the obvious, that Jerusalem is Israel's capital. This is nothing more or less than a recognition of reality. It is also the right thing to do. It's something that has to be done. That is why, consistent with the Jerusalem Embassy Act, I am also directing the State Department to begin preparation to move the American Embassy from Tel Aviv to Jerusalem. This will immediately begin the process of hiring architects, engineers, and planners so that a new embassy, when completed, will be a magnificent tribute to peace. In making these announcements, I also want to make one point very clear. This decision is not intended in any way to reflect a departure from our strong commitment to facilitate a lasting peace agreement. We want an agreement that is a great deal for the Israelis and a great deal for the Palestinians. We are not taking a position of any final status issues, including the specific boundaries of the Israeli sovereignty in Jerusalem or the resolution of contested borders. Those questions are up to the parties involved. The United States remains deeply committed to helping facilitate a peace agreement that is acceptable to both sides. I intend to do everything in my power to help forge such an agreement. Without question, Jerusalem is one of the most sensitive issues in those talks. The United States would support a two-state solution if agreed to by both sides. In the meantime, I call on all parties to maintain the status quo at Jerusalem's holy sites, including the Temple Mount, also known as Haram al-Sharif. Above all, our greatest hope is for peace, the universal yearning in every human soul. With today's action, I reaffirm my administration's longstanding commitment to a future of peace and security for the region. There will, of course, be disagreement and dissent regarding this announcement. But we are confident that ultimately, as we work through these disagreements, we will arrive at a peace and a place far greater in understanding and cooperation. This sacred city should call forth the best in humanity, lifting our sights to what it is possible, not pulling us back and down to the old fights that have become so totally predictable. Peace is never beyond the grasp of those willing to reach it. So today we call for calm, for moderation, and for the voices of tolerance to prevail over the purveyors of hate. Our children should inherit our love, not our conflicts. I repeat the message I delivered at the historic and extraordinary summit in Saudi Arabia earlier this year. The Middle East is a region rich with culture, spirit, and history. Its people are brilliant, proud and diverse, vibrant and strong. But the incredible future awaiting this region is held at bay by bloodshed, ignorance, and terror. Vice President Pence will travel to the region in the coming days to reaffirm our commitment to work with partners throughout the Middle East to defeat radicalism that threatens the hopes and dreams of future generations. It is time for the many who desire peace to expel the extremists from their midst. It is time for all civilized nations and people to respond to disagreement with reasoned debate, not violence. And it is time for young and moderate voices all across the Middle East to claim for themselves a bright and beautiful future. So today, let us rededicate ourselves to a path of mutual understanding and respect. Let us rethink old assumptions and open our hearts and minds to possible and possibilities. And finally, I ask the leaders of the region, political and religious, Israeli and Palestinian, Jewish and Christian and Muslim, to join us in the noble quest for lasting peace. Thank you. God bless you. God bless Israel. God bless the Palestinians. And God bless the United States. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Well, Pastor John Hagee is a New York Times best-selling author, and he's the founder and chairman of Christians United for Israel. He's also the senior pastor of Cornerstone Church in San Antonio.
And he's joining us live from Texas for more. Thanks for joining us, Pastor Hagee. Really appreciate you being with us here on Faith Nation.
We're delighted to be with you today.
Pastor Hagee, what is the significance of what President Trump is doing as it relates to Jerusalem?
What President Trump is doing is one of the most courageous political things that's been done in Washington in a long time. Many presidents have promised to move the embassy and declare Jerusalem as the eternal capital, but they have promised without performing. President Trump, when I spoke to him in the White House about this several weeks ago, he said this very emphatically. He said, "Other presidents have failed you, but I will not disappoint the Christian community in this issue. I will stand with Israel, and we will, at some point in time, move the embassy."
Well, you just led me into my next question. I was curious about some of your interactions with the president on this. Can you tell us a little bit? I know you've visited him at times at the White House. What has that been like? And it seems like he for sure is committed to Israel.
When you meet the president, he's very cordial. He's very warm. He's very engaging. We were there for about 2 hours in an evening meal together, and we spoke about the geopolitical crisis of the Middle East. We spoke about what his thoughts were about moving the embassy. And I talked to him about the significance of moving the embassy in the Jubilee year, because I told him that God measures everything in modules of 50 years. And I said, this is a principle that's carried out in Leviticus, the 25th chapter. I said, if you look at 1917, it was a Jubilee year, and the Balfour Amendment came, and then in 50 years, was 1967, and Jerusalem was reconnected to Israel, and you add 50 to 1967, and you're in 2017. I said, this is the year to move the embassy and make that declaration, because it is a biblical timing of absolute precision. Thank God he's going to do exactly that.
Pastor Hagee, I want to follow up with you on that real quick. Do you get a sense that he understands the biblical significance of this? Or, you know, this is not necessarily in the world he's traveled in for decades.
I think there's a biblical significance to everything that happens to Israel. David writes in the book of Psalms, God has a set time to show grace and mercy to the Jewish people. And that set time is always calibrated by whether the Jewish people are in the land or out of the land. In other words, God's prophetic clock is not ticking until the Jewish people are in the land of Israel. That clock started ticking again when the Balfour Amendment became reality and the Jewish people came back to the state. So I believe at this point in time, Israel is God's stopwatch for everything that happens to every nation, including America, from now until the rapture of the church and beyond.
And Pastor, finally, for Christians who don't know a lot about Israel, why should they care?
Christians should care about Israel because the entirety of the Bible, beginning at Genesis all the way to the end, is God's position paper on the Jewish people. The Bible says, in the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. That means that God owned the earth. As the owner of the earth, after Adam and Eve failed in the garden and Noah's generation failed, God found a man by the name of Abraham, and he made a covenant with him, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, recorded in the book of Genesis, that he was going to give them a strip of real estate in the Middle East, and that piece of real estate would be theirs forever. Forever means today, tomorrow, and forever. It has nothing to do with what the Palestinians think, what the Russians think, what the UK has the opinion of. It belongs to the Jewish people. And Israel is the gateway to God's blessing in the Bible. Genesis 12, I will bless those who bless you. World history can be summed up in one sentence. The nations that blessed Israel were blessed of God, and the nations that cursed Israel were cursed of God. The Egyptians cursed the Jewish people, and God wiped them out. He drowned their army in the Red Sea. He sent plagues to destroy their wealth. Where are the Babylonians? They're gone. Where are the Persians? They're gone. Where is the Roman Empire? It's gone. Where is the former Great Britain? It's now reduced to one island. Where are the lunatic Nazis who followed Adolf Hitler? They have been wiped off the face of the earth. Where is Israel? It is alive. It's prospering. It's growing. It is still the apple of God's eye. The Bible says that God's eyes are on the city of Jerusalem every day and constantly. So God's timepiece, Israel, is clicking right on schedule.
Below the two numbers, I saw the word or the number 2017 written there.
In the இரண்டு ஆண்டுகளுக்கு கீழாக நான் 2017 ஆண்டு எழுதப்பட்டிருக்கிறதை நான் கண்டேன்.
And the angel Michael said.
அப்பொழுது தேவதூதர் மைக்கேல் என்னை பார்த்து சொன்னார்.
Another major war is planned.
இன்னொரு பெரிய யுத்தம் பிளான் பண்ணப்பட்டிருக்கிறது என்று.
A major change and shift in government and land is coming.
மிகவும் ஒரு முக்கியமான மாற்றம் அரசாங்கத்திலும் அந்த பட்டணத்திலும் ஏற்பட போகிறது.
And on March 11, 2015,
மார்ச் 11ஆம் தேதி 2015ஆம் ஆண்டிலே,
while I was waiting on God,
தேவனுடைய பாதத்திலே நான் காத்து கொண்டிருந்த பொழுது,
I had a heavenly experience.
ஒரு பரலோக அனுபவத்தை நான் பெற்றேன்.
I saw myself in heaven.
நான் அப்பொழுது பரலோகத்தில் இருக்கிறதை போல உணர்ந்தேன்.
And I was standing before the Lord Jesus Christ.
ஆண்டவராகிய இயேசு கிறிஸ்துவுக்கு முன்பாக நின்று கொண்டேன்.
And I saw two saints standing together with the Lord Jesus.
ரெண்டு பரிசுத்தவான்கள் ஆண்டவராகிய இயேசு கிறிஸ்துவோடு கூட நின்று கொண்டிருப்பதை நான்
One I recognize as the prophet Moses.
ஒன்று தீர்க்கதரிசி மோசே என்பதை நான் கண்டுபிடித்துக் கொண்டேன்.
And the other I recognize as the prophet Jeremiah.
இன்னொரு தீர்க்கதரிசி எரேமியா என்பதை நான் உணர்ந்தேன்.
And after speaking to me about some matters,
ஒரு சில காரியத்தை குறித்து அவர்கள் என்னிடத்தில் பேசின பின்பு,
the Lord Jesus turned to the prophet Jeremiah and said,
ஆண்டவராகிய இயேசு கிறிஸ்து எரேமியா தீர்க்கதரிசியை நோக்கி பார்த்து அப்பொழுது என்னிடத்தில் சொன்னார்,
Teach him about the 70 years.
அவருக்கு 70 வருடத்தை குறித்து கற்றுக்கொடு என்று.
So then the prophet Jeremiah came near me.
அப்பொழுது தீர்க்கதரிசி எரேமியா என் அருகில் வந்தார்.
And he said, 70 years in the history of Israel is very, very significant.
70 வருடம் இஸ்ரேலின் சரித்திரத்திலே மிகவும் ஒரு முக்கியமான ஒன்று.
And there is going to come a turning point in the history of Israel in the year 2017.
2017ஆம் ஆண்டிலே ஒரு பெரிய திருப்பு முனை இஸ்ரேல் சரித்திரத்திலே ஏற்பட போகிறது.
He said that will be the 70th year of the history of Israel since its formation.
அது உருவாக்கப்பட்ட நாட்களிலிருந்து அதுதான் 70வது ஆண்டாக இருக்கும்.
I was quite dumbfounded when this was said.
இது என் இடத்துல சொல்லப்பட்ட பொழுது எனக்கு இதை குறித்து ஒன்றும் தெரியவில்லை.
In my mind I made a mental calculation.
என்னுடைய மனதிலே ஒரு கணக்கை போட்டேன்.
இஸ்ரேல் கெயின் இண்டிபெண்டன்ஸ் இன் தி இயர் 1948
1948 ஆண்டு இஸ்ரேல் தன்னுடைய சுதந்திரத்தை பெற்றுக் கொண்டது
இஃப் யூ ஆட் 70 இயர்ஸ்
அதற்கு 70 நாங்கள் நாம் சேர்த்தோம் என்றால்
இட் will be the year 2018
2018 ஆண்டுதான் வரும்
and not 2017
2017 அல்ல
so very respectfully I asked the saint Jeremiah about this
மிகவும் மரியாதையோடு கூட தீர்க்கதரிசி எரேமியாவை நோக்கி நான் இதை கேட்டேன்
so he said no you are wrong
அவர் சொன்னார் இல்லை நீ தவறாக கணக்கு போட்டு இருக்கிறாய் என்று
the count should be from the time when the covenant was first signed
உடன்படிக்கை முதலாவது எப்பொழுது கையெழுத்திடப்பட்டதோ அந்த நேரத்திலிருந்து கணக்கெடுக்கப்பட வேண்டும் என்று
so I found that the state of Israel was first planned and signed by the United Nations on November 29, 1947
1947 ஆண்டு நவம்பர் 29 தேதிதான் முதலாவது ஐக்கிய நாடுகள் இஸ்ரேலே ஒரு தனி மாநிலமாக கையெழுத்திடப்பட்டது
So that day, in that year, the agreement was made.
அந்த நாளில்தான் அந்த உடன்படிக்கையானது கையெழுத்திடப்பட்டது
There should be a state of Israel.
இஸ்ரேல் என்ற ஒரு தனி மாநிலம் இருக்க வேண்டும் என்று
1947 plus 70 equals to 2017.
1947 ஆண்டுகளோட கூட நாம் 70 சேர்க்கும் பொழுது அது 2017 ஆண்டிலே வந்து முடிகிறது.
This is a historic day. Jerusalem has been the capital of the Jewish people for 3,000 years. It's been the capital of Israel for nearly 70 years. It was here that our temple stood, our kings ruled, our prophets preached. Jerusalem has been the focus of our hopes, our dreams, our prayers for 3 millennia. From every corner of the earth, our people yearn to return to Jerusalem, to touch its golden stones, to walk its hallowed streets. So it's rare to be able to speak of new and genuine milestones in the glorious history of this city. Yet today's pronouncement by President Trump is such an occasion. We're profoundly grateful for the President for his courageous and just decision to recognize Jerusalem as the capital of Israel and to prepare for the opening of the U.S. Embassy here. This decision reflects the President's commitment to an ancient but enduring truth, to fulfilling his promises, and to advancing peace. The president's decision is an important step towards peace, for there is no peace that doesn't include Jerusalem as the capital of the state of Israel. I call on all countries that seek peace to join the United States in recognizing Jerusalem as Israel's capital and to move their embassies here. I share President Trump's commitment to advancing peace between Israel and all of our neighbors, including the Palestinians. This has been our goal from Israel's first day, and we will continue to work with the President and his team to make that dream of peace come true. I also want to make clear, there will be no change whatsoever to the status quo at the holy sites. Israel will always ensure freedom of worship for Jews, Christians, and Muslims alike. President Trump, thank you for today's historic decision to recognize Jerusalem as Israel's capital. The Jewish people and the Jewish state will be forever grateful.
delay no longer.
இனி காலம் செல்லாது.
The Lord Jesus is coming again in our days.
Subscribe to our YouTube channel to receive regular prophetic news, messages and updates. Click on the bell button in order to receive instant notification from us.
Jerusalem, as I did on my trip to Israel earlier this year. Jerusalem is not just the heart of three great religions, but it is now also the heart of one of the most successful democracies in the world. Over the past seven decades, the Israeli people have built a country where Jews, Muslims, and Christians, and people of all faiths are free to live and worship according to their conscience and according to their beliefs. Jerusalem is today and must remain a place where Jews pray at the Western Wall, where Christians walk the Stations of the Cross, and where Muslims worship at Al-Aqsa Mosque. However, through all of these years, presidents representing the United States have declined to officially recognize Jerusalem as Israel's capital. In fact, we have declined to acknowledge any Israeli capital at all. But today we finally acknowledge the obvious, that Jerusalem is Israel's capital. This is nothing more or less than a recognition of reality. It is also the right thing to do. It's something that has to be done. That is why, consistent with the Jerusalem Embassy Act, I am also directing the State Department to begin preparation to move the American Embassy from Tel Aviv to Jerusalem. This will immediately begin the process of hiring architects, engineers and planners, so that a new embassy, when completed, will be a magnificent tribute to peace. In making these announcements, I also want to make one point very clear. This decision is not intended in any way to reflect a departure from our strong commitment to facilitate a lasting peace agreement. We want an agreement that is a great deal for the Israelis and a great deal for the Palestinians. We are not taking a position of any final status issues, including the specific boundaries of the Israeli sovereignty in Jerusalem or the resolution of contested borders. Those questions are up to the parties involved. The United States remains deeply committed to helping facilitate a peace agreement that is
the freedom of Jerusalem, and that any negotiations that are to take place are going to have to be done by the Israelis themselves, and the Israelis are going to have to make decisions about what to do with their capital. Well, it's a ground shift, and it's a recognition of a reality that's necessary in order for real peace to be achieved in the region, not based on false stupidities that have been promulgated for the last couple of decades.
So they have 6 months to actually do it. They have a six-month waiver to actually do it. Monday was the deadline to actually make the announcement, so today we're going to get it today officially at 1 o'clock. But it will remain a divided city. That won't change. Does that bother you?
Well, I mean, it will remain a divided city because the fact is that the authorities have basically allowed terrorism to spread among the Palestinians, and East Jerusalem has largely been occupied by the same people it's been occupied for the last seven decades, namely Muslims who live there. That part of the city is very dangerous. It's been very dangerous ever since I can remember, long before I was born. The fact is that when I visited Israel for the first time when I was 16 years old, Israeli soldiers had to guard us as we came out of the tunnels under the Western Wall into East Jerusalem, which again, the capital of Israel. If you are a Jew and you walk into East Jerusalem, your life is in danger. If you're an Arab and you walk into West Jerusalem, there's no problem at all, which signifies exactly why Jerusalem should be under Jewish control and not under Muslim control.
Thank you. When I came into office, I promised to look at the world's challenges with open eyes and very fresh thinking. We cannot solve our problems by making the same failed assumptions and repeating the same failed strategies of the past. Old challenges demand new approaches. My announcement today marks the beginning of a new approach to conflict between Israel and the Palestinians. In 1995, Congress adopted the Jerusalem Embassy Act, urging the federal government to relocate the American embassy to Jerusalem and to recognize that that city, and so importantly, is Israel's capital. This act passed Congress by an overwhelming bipartisan majority and was reaffirmed by unanimous vote of the Senate only 6 months ago. Yet for over 20 years, every previous American president has exercised the law's waiver, refusing to move the U.S. Embassy to Jerusalem or to recognize Jerusalem as Israel's capital city. Presidents issued these waivers under the belief that delaying the recognition of Jerusalem would advance the cause of peace. Some say they lacked courage, but they made their best judgments brief. Above all, our greatest hope is for peace, the universal yearning in every human soul. With today's action, I reaffirm my administration's longstanding commitment to a future of peace and security for the region. There will, of course, be disagreement and dissent regarding this announcement. But we are confident that ultimately, as we work through these disagreements, we will arrive at a peace and a place far greater in understanding and cooperation. This sacred city should call forth the best in humanity, lifting our sights to what it is possible, not pulling us back and down to the old fights that have become so totally predictable. Peace is never beyond the grasp of those willing to reach it. So today we call for calm, for moderation, and for the voices of tolerance to prevail over the purveyors of hate. Our children should inherit our love, not our conflicts. I repeat the message I delivered at the historic and extraordinary summit in Saudi Arabia earlier this year. The Middle East is a region rich with culture, spirit, and history. Its people are brilliant, proud, and diverse, vibrant, and strong. But the incredible future awaiting this region is held at bay by bloodshed, ignorance, and terror. Vice President Pence will travel to the region in the coming days to reaffirm our commitment to work with partners throughout the Middle East to defeat radicalism that threatens the hopes and dreams of future generations. It is time for the many who desire peace to expel the extremists from their midst. It is time for all civilized nations and people to respond to disagreement with reasoned debate, not violence. And it is time for young and moderate voices all across the Middle East to claim for themselves a bright and beautiful future. So today, let us rededicate ourselves to a path of mutual understanding and respect. Let us rethink old assumptions and
reduce to one island. Where are the lunatic Nazis who followed Adolf Hitler? They have been wiped off the face of the earth. Where is Israel? It is alive, it's prospering, it's growing, it is still the apple of God's eye. The Bible says that God's eyes are on the city of Jerusalem every day and constantly. So God's timepiece, Israel, is clicking right on schedule.
Below the two numbers, I saw the word or the number 2017 written there.
In the இரண்டு ஆண்டுகளுக்கு கீழாக நான் 2017 ஆண்டு எழுதப்பட்டிருக்கிறதை நான் கண்டேன்.
And the angel Michael said.
அப்பொழுது தேவதூதர் மைக்கேல் என்னை பார்த்து சொன்னார்.
Another major war is planned.
இன்னொரு பெரிய யுத்தம் பிளான் பண்ணப்பட்டிருக்கிறது என்று.
A major change and shift in government and land is coming.
மிகவும் ஒரு முக்கியமான மாற்றம் அரசாங்கத்திலும் அந்த பட்டணத்திலும் ஏற்பட போகிறது.
And on March 11, 2015,
மார்ச் 11ஆம் தேதி 2015 ஆண்டிலே,
while I was waiting on God,
தேவனுடைய பாதத்திலே நான் காத்துக் கொண்டிருந்த பொழுது,
I had a heavenly experience.
ஒரு பரலோக அனுபவத்தை நான் பெற்றேன்.
I saw myself in heaven.
நான் அப்பொழுது பரலோகத்தில் இருக்கிறதை போல உணர்ந்தேன்.
And I was standing before the Lord Jesus Christ.
ஆண்டவராகிய இயேசு கிறிஸ்துவுக்கு முன்பாக நின்று கொண்டேன்.
And I saw two saints standing together with the Lord Jesus.
ரெண்டு பரிசுத்தவான்கள் ஆண்டவராகிய இயேசு கிறிஸ்துவோடு கூட நின்று கொண்டிருப்பதை நான்.
One I recognize as the prophet Moses.
ஒன்று தீர்க்கதரிசி மோசே என்பதை நான் கண்டுபிடித்துக் கொண்டேன்.
And the other I recognize as the prophet Jeremiah.
இன்னொரு தீர்க்கதரிசி எரேமியா என்பதை நான் உணர்ந்தேன்.
And after speaking to me about some matters,
ஒரு சில காரியத்தை குறித்து அவர்கள் என்னிடத்தில் பேசின பின்பு,
the Lord Jesus turned to the prophet Jeremiah and said,
ஆண்டவராகிய இயேசு கிறிஸ்து எரேமியா தீர்க்கதரிசியை நோக்கி பார்த்து அப்பொழுது என்னிடத்தில் சொன்னார்,
teach him about the 70 years.
அவருக்கு 70 வருடத்தை குறித்து கற்றுக்கொடு என்று.
So then the prophet Jeremiah came near me.
அப்பொழுது தீர்க்கதரிசி எரேமியா என் அருகில் வந்தார்.
And he said, 70 years in the history of Israel is very, very significant.
70 வருடம் இஸ்ரேலின் சரித்திரத்திலே மிகவும் ஒரு முக்கியமான ஒன்று.
And there is going to come a turning point in the history of Israel in the year 2017.
2017 ஆண்டிலே ஒரு பெரிய திருப்பு முனை இஸ்ரேல் சரித்திரத்திலே ஏற்பட போகிறது.
He said that will be the 70th year of the history of Israel since its formation.
அது உருவாக்கப்பட்ட நாட்களிலிருந்து அதுதான் 70வது ஆண்டாக இருக்கும்.
I was quite dumbfounded when this was said.
இது என்னிடத்தில் சொல்லப்பட்ட பொழுது எனக்கு இதை குறித்து ஒன்றும்
of the history of Israel since its formation.
அது உருவாக்கப்பட்ட நாட்களிலிருந்து அதுதான் 70வது ஆண்டாக இருக்கும்.
Therefore I have determined that it is time to officially recognize Jerusalem as the capital of Israel. We will move the American embassy to the eternal capital of the Jewish people, Jerusalem.
And the crowd roared, but would it happen? Would if he became president, would President Trump actually do this?
Presidents before have said it. President looks like he's going to do it.
I know, he's saying he's going to do it today at 1 o'clock. I think that makes Ben Shapiro pretty happy. He's the editor-in-chief of the Daily Wire, syndicated columnist and host of the Ben Shapiro Show. Ben, what are your thoughts? When did you hear that he was going to do this?
Oh, I had heard actually sort of off the radar last week, and I'd kept it under wraps. I was pretty excited about that. It's obviously an act of not only political bravery, but moral courage to move the embassy, but just to recognize Israel as Jerusalem as Israel's capital. The absurdity of the U.S. policy suggesting that Jerusalem was not Israel's capital has resulted in idiocies like the fact that my niece, who was born in Jerusalem, it says on her passport Jerusalem, and then it doesn't say which country she's from. Jerusalem is only important to the world because of Judaism. It's important to Christianity because it was first important to Judaism. It's important to Islam because it was first important to Judaism. Jerusalem is mentioned hundreds of times in the Jewish texts. Jerusalem is in the Israeli national anthem. The culmination of Jewish history really was in 1967 with the recapture and the unification of of Jerusalem under Judaic rule. The freedom of Jerusalem was only assured, by the way, because of that Jewish rule. What President Trump is doing is not just a recognition of reality, it's also an act of political usefulness, because all of the negotiations that have been happening for the last 20 years, for most of my lifetime, all of those negotiations have been preconditioned on stupidity, that Israel is going to give up its eternal capital, which is insane. I mean, in order to understand how dumb that is, you have to think that for Israel, Jerusalem is about 1,000 times more important than Washington, D.C. is to the United States. I mean, the founders put Washington, D.C. on a swamp because they just wanted it to be not part of any state. The reason that Jerusalem is where it is because the Bible says it is where it is. There's a religious adherence to Jerusalem that doesn't exist for normal capitals around the world. And for President Trump to recognize that this isn't going anywhere, that the freedom of Israel is just inherently connected with the freedom of Jerusalem, and that any negotiations that are to take place are going to have to be done by the Israelis themselves, and the Israelis are going to have to make decisions about what to do with their capital. Well, it's a ground shift, and it's a recognition of a reality that's necessary in order for real peace to be achieved in the region, not based on...
of reality. It is also the right thing to do. It's something that has to be done. That is why, consistent with the Jerusalem Embassy Act, I am also directing the State Department to begin preparation to move the American Embassy from Tel Aviv to Jerusalem. This will immediately begin the process of hiring architects, engineers, and planners so that a new embassy, when completed, will be a magnificent tribute to peace. In making these announcements, I also want to make one point very clear. This decision is not intended in any way to reflect a departure from our strong commitment to facilitate a lasting peace agreement. We want an agreement that is a great deal for the Israelis and a great deal for the Palestinians. We are not taking a position of any final status issues, including the specific boundaries of the Israeli sovereignty in Jerusalem or the resolution of contested borders. Those questions are up to the parties involved. The United States remains deeply committed to helping facilitate a peace agreement that is acceptable to both sides. I intend to do everything in my power to help forge such an agreement. Without question, Jerusalem is one of the most sensitive issues in those talks. The United States would support a two-state solution if agreed to by both sides. In the meantime, I call on all parties to maintain the status quo at Jerusalem's holy sites, including the Temple Mount, also known as Haram al-Sharif. Above all, our greatest hope is for peace, the universal yearning in every human soul. With today's action, I reaffirm my administration's longstanding commitment to a future of peace and security for the region. There will, of course, be disagreement and dissent regarding this announcement. But we are confident that ultimately, as we work through these disagreements, we will arrive at a peace and a place far greater in understanding and cooperation. This sacred city should call forth the best in you.
For the number 2017 written there.
In the இரண்டு ஆண்டுகளுக்கு கீழாக நான் 2017 ஆண்டு எழுதப்பட்டிருக்கிறதை நான் கண்டேன்.
And the angel Michael said.
அப்பொழுது தேவதூதர் மைக்கேல் என்னை பார்த்து சொன்னார்.
Another major war is planned.
இன்னொரு பெரிய யுத்தம் பிளான் பண்ணப்பட்டிருக்கிறது என்று.
A major change and shift in government and land is coming.
மிகவும் ஒரு முக்கியமான மாற்றம் அரசாங்கத்திலும் அந்த பட்டணத்திலும் ஏற்பட போகிறது.
And on March 11, 2015,
மார்ச் 11ஆம் தேதி 2015ஆம் ஆண்டிலே,
while I was waiting on God,
தேவனுடைய பாதத்திலே நான் காத்துக் கொண்டிருந்த பொழுது,
I had a heavenly experience.
ஒரு பரலோக அனுபவத்தை நான் பெற்றேன்.
I saw myself in heaven.
நான் அப்பொழுது பரலோகத்தில் இருக்கிறதை போல உணர்ந்தேன்.
And I was standing before the Lord Jesus Christ.
ஆண்டவராகிய இயேசு கிறிஸ்துவுக்கு முன்பாக நின்று கொண்டேன்.
I saw two saints standing together with the Lord Jesus.
ரெண்டு பரிசுத்தவான்கள் ஆண்டவராக இயேசு கிறிஸ்துவோடு கூட நின்று கொண்டிருப்பதை நான்.
One I recognize as the prophet Moses.
ஒன்று தீர்க்கதரிசி மோசே என்பதை நான் கண்டுபிடித்துக் கொண்டேன்.
And the other I recognized as the prophet Jeremiah.
And
after speaking to me about some
matters,
the Lord Jesus turned to the prophet Jeremiah and said,
Teach
him about the 70 years.
அவருக்கு 70 வருடத்தை குறித்து கற்றுக்கொடு என்று.
So then the prophet Jeremiah came near me.
அப்பொழுது தீர்க்கதரிசி எரேமியா என் அருகில் வந்தார்.
And he said, 70 years in the history of Israel is very, very significant.
70 வருடம் இஸ்ரேலின் சரித்திரத்திலே மிகவும் ஒரு முக்கியமான ஒன்று.
And there is going to come a turning point in the history of Israel in the year 2017.
2017ஆம் ஆண்டிலே ஒரு பெரிய திருப்பு முனை இஸ்ரேல் சரித்திரத்திலே ஏற்பட போகிறது.
He said that will be the 70th year of the history of Israel since its formation.
அது உருவாக்கப்பட்ட நாட்களிலிருந்து அதுதான் 70வது ஆண்டாக இருக்கும்.
I was quite dumbfounded when this was said.
இது என் இடத்துல சொல்லப்பட்ட பொழுது எனக்கு இதை குறித்து ஒன்றும் தெரியவில்லை.
In my mind I made a mental calculation.
என்னுடைய மனதிலே ஒரு கணக்கை போட்டேன்.
Israel gained independence in the year 1948. If you add 70 years,
it will be the year 2018. 2018-ஆம் ஆண்டு தான் வரும்.
And not 2017.
அல்ல.
So very respectfully I asked the Saint Jeremiah about this.
மிகவும்